Let's quickly summarize how a language interpreter works. For regular expressions, we have patterns like A or B plus, which define languages. A language is a set of strings like A, B, AB, BA, and so on, defined by that pattern. And then we have interpreters like Matset, which in this case takes a pattern and a text and returns a list of strings or a set of strings. And so we say that Matset is an interpreter because it takes a description of the language, namely a pattern, as a data structure and operates over that pattern. Here's the definition of Matset. You see it looks at the pattern, breaks out its components, and then the first thing it does is this big case statement to figure out what type of operator we have and to do the appropriate thing. So there's an inherent inefficiency here in that the pattern is defined once, and it's always the same pattern over a long string of text and maybe over many possible texts. We want to apply the same pattern to many texts. And yet, every time we get to that pattern, we're doing this same process of trying to figure out what operator we have, when in fact we should already know that because the pattern is static, is constant. So this is kind of repeated work. We're doing this over and over again for no good reason. But there's another kind of interpreter called a compiler, which does that work all at once. At the very first time when the pattern is defined, we do the work of figuring out which part of the pattern are which, so we don't have to repeat that every time we apply the pattern to a text. So where an interpreter takes, say, a pattern and a text and operates on those, a compiler has two steps. In the first step, there's a compilation function which takes just the pattern and returns a compiled object, which we'll call C. And then there's the execution of that compiled object, where we take C and we apply that to the text to get the result. Here, work can be done repeatedly every time we have a text. Here, the work is split up. Some of it is done in the compilation stage to get this compiled object, and then the rest of it is done every time we get a new text. Let's see how that works. Here's the definition of the interpreter. Let's focus just on this line here. So this says, if the op is a literal, then we return this result. And the way I'm going to change this interpreter into a compiler is I'm going to take the individual statements like this that were in the interpreter, and I'm going to throw them into various parts of a compiler, and each of those parts is going to live in the constructor for the individual type of pattern. So we have a constructor. Literal takes a string as input, and let's return a tuple that just represents what we have, and then the interpreter deals with that. Now, we're going to have literal act as a compiler, so what it's going to do is return a function that's going to do the work. So what is this saying? We have the exact same expression here as we had before, but what we're saying is that as soon as we construct a literal, rather than having that return a tuple, what it's returning is a function, which is a function from the text to the result that Matset would have given us.